क्या घट रहा है, किसके साथ घट रहा है,
कैसे, कब, क्यों, कहां, ये भी जानेंगे 92.7 बिग एफएम पर नितिन के साथ। यूं ही सुनो सुनाओ, लाइफ बनाओ।
250 मिलियन लिसनर्स ट्यूनिंग इन टू 215 रेडियो स्टेशंस अक्रॉस 80 लोकेशंस। India's $200 million radio industry is on a high note, with private players raking in the moolah these past 15 years.
Radio Mirchi 98.3 FM, Anant aur Saurabh ke saath aap sun rahe hain, aur ho kafi kuch raha hai yahan pe DL.
And now it's time for the big push that everyone's been waiting for, the phase 3 of radio licensing in India.
बेचारे अब चंडीगढ़ वालों को, मोहाली वालों को क्या होगा पता नहीं।
The phase 3 licensing will take radio into the deepest part of this country and build a really good model for networks like us.
So just how deep is deep? The government is expected to grant 700 licenses across 300 cities and towns. That's 3 times the number of channels and 4 times the reach available today. Needless to say that it's the large, deep-pocketed players who will bag most of the new licenses.
A lot of the economic growth is really happening in the smaller towns. So we hope to be present over there. We don't have television as a medium to worry about in the smaller markets. So I think radio will have a far bigger play in the smaller markets.
Small is big. Critical to the success of India's radio industry, which is completely dependent on advertising for its revenues. The industry expects advertising revenues to grow by 30-40% because they will have a strong foothold in regional markets.
It's going to be a very exciting phase for the entire industry, primarily from the fact that finally radio will become a national medium, because the geographical expansion that is envisaged in phase 3 is really going to be huge, from a situation from 91 cities to 280 cities that the FM footprint is going to expand to. So certainly that is going to be a game changer.
So how will the game change? From a smaller player's point of view, the going can get tougher. That's because it's mandatory for every branch in every city or town to generate content individually. That increases costs, particularly in non-metros, where staff costs account for a chunk of the overall expenses. Add to that the fact that not more than 50% of the broadcast equipment can be hired or leased on a long-term basis. And what you have is an unviable business.
They have to understand also in phase 3, maximum of the station in the small cities, in D and E cities, where the revenue model is very less.
Radio City 91.1.
That problem can be solved if radio companies are allowed to network content or use content from a common pool.
Good morning.
And here, it's the smaller players who are in the dock, because the larger players have the wherewithal to wait and watch until the policy changes.
Wonderful, fantastic.
What we're not able to do in television because of the structure of distribution is have local TV channels. You know, everybody in the whole country gets the Kannada channel or the Bengali channel or the Marathi channel. Whereas with radio, you are able to do that, because radio stations are local. So that creates a whole new opportunity to monetize. And so yes, I think radio is going to do fabulously.
हमने ऐसी आरती चलाई क्रिकेट की कि वर्ल्ड कप खुद चलकर हमारे घर आ गया।
Apart from dishing out local flavors, phase 3 of radio reforms is likely to empower private players to generate news as content. As of now, all they do is play music.
Content is, you know, right now is very regulated, as you know. We can only play music and at best some jock talks here and there. We're not allowed to play any kind of news, or we're not allowed to even cover any kind of important issues, because it's a purely a music station.
Oh, please go ahead, yeah. This is your FM, my FM, aapka FM. Batai, kaunsa gana sunna chahte hain.
But a music station sources content from third parties. And that is the big problem for smaller players, who have to shell out as much as 60 lakh rupees per station per year on account of royalties. For instance, MyFM paid nearly 23% of its revenues as royalties last year, larger players are better off by comparison.
अच्छा, मधुर भंडारकर मेरे साथ हैं और दो बच्चे मेरे साथ हैं मुंबई, आपको अभी पता चलता है, साथ में रहो।
ENIL and Reliance Broadcast Network paid 7% and 12% of their revenues as royalty in 2010.
Oh my God!
अब जो भी हो, बहुत सारा पंगा हो गया है, बहुत सारा बवाल हो गया है कि इतनी मेहनत करके।
But even that is on the higher side compared to the 2 to 5% average royalty rates paid by radio companies worldwide.
Music industry was asking for revenues, well, at least 20% of revenues is what their card rate says. Which was an unviable demand. If you look at radio in other developed nations, for example, be it UK, be it Canada, be it the US, it is a percentage. And in a lot of countries, it is between 0 to 3%.
Welcome to the show. If you're just joining us, we have a very special guest today.
Like their counterparts abroad, Indian companies have been advocating a similar revenue sharing model versus the current fixed cost royalty model.
This is Rahul Singh. Take a listen.
The Copyright Board has recommended sharing 2% of the radio channel's ad revenues with music companies. The Bombay High Court has upheld that. But the matter is still pending with the Supreme Court. But even before the matter completely settled, radio stations have tuned in to the new revenue sharing regime.
Number yaad hai na? 6696-9191.
The royalty issue, which formed quite a problem for the radio companies, at least the in the smaller towns, that is in the process of being resolved. You know, there has been a decision on it. It is being challenged, but if we get to a revenue share structure, that will solve part of the problem. And the radio industry is getting to a scale where a couple of companies have become EBITDA positive, etc.
For instance, in the first three quarters of 2010, Fever FM saw a minor profit before interest and tax compared to losses of 25% in the previous years. Others like Radio and My FM saw a decline in their losses during this period. But to attract investors, radio companies also need to get the right advertisers. And that is the weak link.
थोड़ा सा वक्त लगेगा, लेकिन हाँ, मैं इतना ज़रूर आपको दावा कर सकता हूँ कि चीज़ें ठीक हो जाएंगी, ठीक है ना?
Radio must prove to the advertiser that it can add value to the brand emotional equity. The moment you know it can add something to the equity of a brand, people are willing to spend little more money. Otherwise, you only take radio for a local promotion.
Radio is being used as, I think, a reminder medium. If the ad is running on the TV or print or say let's do a reminder as a radio.
Radio as a channel itself is very challenging, you know, the medium itself, because you don't have the support of a visual impact. So you just have to rely on the audio to connect with your audiences.